occasions like this that I get a chance to do the talking. His Excellency Governor McCusker of Tony McCusker, Premier and Mrs. Barnett, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for this afternoon. It's I like understatements, but to say that we're blown away by this is the greatest understatement of all time. About 6 weeks ago, we had a phone call from Kelly in Canberra to say that we'd been nominated as a finalist, and we were just over the moon with that. We thought, well, if we can be a finalist, that is absolutely fantastic. It's just nice to be acknowledged in that way. So thank you for that. And just a bit of history. When Amanda died in 1997, it's fair to say that no one knew anything about meningococcal disease. And when we picked ourselves up off the canvas, Lorraine came up hiding and said we need to do something about this. And the Amanda Young Foundation was subsequently formed. And our first chairman said that you'd stuck into it because after 3 years, no one will remember Amanda. And 15 years down the track, the last 6 months have probably been the most productive and satisfying in the history of the foundation. In April, we had our 12th Young Leaders Camp, which was fantastic. We had a record ball in May. In early August, we had our fourth meningococcal conference for over 100 medical people. We brought an expert across from overseas, and we got the support of all the local doctors and specialists, and that was another great achievement. We then went on to, we went over to Canberra and spoke to Ken Wyatt and his friends, and we're hoping for them to back a vaccine for meningococcal B, and that hopefully comes out in the new year. We had a wonderful meningococcal day when we doubled our achievements of 2011. We had 20,000 families involved in 300 preschool centres. And then we finished it off with opening Amanda's Garden. But also, I forgot to mention that on the 30th of June, we were fortunate, thanks to the ABC, the ABC Gardening Australia came out to our place, and Josh Burden and David DeVos did a segment on Amanda and Amanda's Garden and what we've tried to achieve. And we're very proud about that because that went Australia-wide. And that's everything we do, all our fundraising and awareness is aimed at telling people about the meningococcal disease, because it's such a nasty and swift and lethal nature disease. It's just so important. There's about a 12-hour window of opportunity between getting a good and a bad result. It's just so important that people know the symptoms and get to an emergency department. Princess Margaret Hospital is fantastic, Royal Perth. Major hospitals, great emergency departments, will do the right thing and administer a shot of penicillin, provided you get there quickly enough. So that's, I guess, been our message, which we've been proud to put over. We've had quite a few good feedback where people said that the event, the information that the foundation put out was instrumental in getting the difference between getting good and bad results, which is a great motivating factor for us. On the way, we've been privileged to have the assistance of some fantastic people, the intensive care specialists, a microbiologist, and a great number on the medical side of people who helped us out. And also our corporate supporters and partners, and also our volunteers. We, Lorraine and I, can't do this on our own. We're just so lucky to have so many committed volunteers who put their hand out and help us run our balls, run our garden bait, and they're great supporters for us. So thanks to them, really. The award is a testament to the support that we've had from of our wonderful volunteers. So, Thank you, dear. Really, Lorraine has been the inspiration, as I said, she, when we were on the canvas, she got up quickly and came out fighting, and we've continued the fight. So thank you very much. That's indeed a fantastic honour to receive you. Thank you.